Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2042, If Error and IFNA. I'll be podcasting all of my tips from this book. Click the I in the top right-hand corner to get to the entire playlist. All right, let's go back to the old days, Excel 2007 or before. If you needed to prevent the NA from a VLOOKUP formula such as this one, we used to do this crazy thing. Scoop all of the characters of the formula except for the equal sign, out control C to put it on the clipboard. Equal if, open parenthesis, is NA, open parenthesis. Press the N key to get to the end. If it's NA, then we say not found, comma, otherwise, we do the VLOOKUP, right? I paste it in there, and look how long that formula is. Control Enter, add a parenthesis right there. Control Enter. All right, look, that's sweet. All right, but the problem is, while it solves the problem of the NA, every single formula is doing the VLOOKUP twice. It does it once to say, hey, is this an error? Oh, no, it's not an error. Let's go do it again. So it takes twice as long to do all of these VLOOKUPs. In Excel 2010, they gave us the awesome, awesome formula of if error. Now, I know that sounds like what we had before, is error or is error, but this is if error. And the way that it works, you take any formula that might return an error, and then you say equal if error. There's the formula, comma, what to do if it's not, if it's an error, so not found. All right, now, the beautiful thing about this is, let's say you had 1,000 VLOOKUPs to do and 980 of them work. For the 980, it just does the VLOOKUP. It's not an error, it returns the answer. It never goes on to do the second VLOOKUP. That's the beauty about IFERROR. Excel, IFERROR came along in Excel 2010, but of course, the one really stupid problem here is that the table itself is returning an error, right? Someone had zero quantity, revenue divided by quantity, and so we're getting a division by zero error there, and that error is also going to be detected as an error by if error, right? And it's going to look like the Mr. Excel is not found. He is found, it's just that whoever built this table didn't do a good job of building this table. All right, so choice number one, Excel 2013 or newer, switch over to the function they added in 2013, that doesn't look for all errors, it only looks for NA. Control Enter, and now we'll get the not found, for Excel is fun, but Mr. Excel is returning the division by zero error. Really though, what we should be doing is out here in this formula, we should be handling this formula to prevent that division by zero in the first place. So equal if error, see this works for all kinds of things, press the N key to get to the end comma, and then what to do. I would always put a zero here as the average price. I had a manager once that says, oh no, that's not mathematically correct. You have to put in quotes N period M period for not meaningful. Exactly like that. That's crazy how all my managers drove me crazy with their crazy requests. So let's copy that down. Base special formulas, Alt ESF. Now we get a not meaningful error here. The not found is found by the if error, and the not meaningful is actually the result of the VLOOKUP. Alright, so a couple of different ways to go. Probably the safe thing to do here is to use if NA, provided you have Excel 2013 and everyone you're sharing your workbook with has Excel 2013. This book, plus a whole bunch of others are in this book, is dripping with spicy tips. 200 pages, easy to read, full color. Awesome, awesome book. Check it out. Click the I in the top right-hand corner. You can buy the book. All right, episode recap. Back in the old days, we'd use a long formula, equal if, open paren, is NA, open paren, the formula, comma, zero, otherwise the formula. The formula was calculated twice, which is horrible for VLOOKUPs. Starting in Excel 2010, equal if error, just put the formula once, comma, what to do if it's an error. If error, though, treats division by zero errors the same as not applicable errors or not available errors. So starting Excel 2013, the IFNA function works just like if error, but it'll detect only the pound NA errors. This tip, by the way, suggested by readers Justin Fishman, Stephen Gilmer, and Excel by Joe. Thanks to them for suggesting this, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.